Of the 100,000 native carnivores that are killed in the U.S. by USDA Wildlife Services, about 70 to 80,000 are coyotes.
We have an all-out war on coyotes in this country, and so far all it's succeeded in doing is making more coyotes.
Lethal control is largely ineffective, and in most cases it'll even make the problem worse.
And we kill hundreds and hundreds of thousands of them in horrible ways.
Many of these animals are killed with indiscriminate lethal methods, including aerial gunning, snares, poisons.
Well, I don't see any use in killing all the animals. I mean, they all need to be here for one reason or another.
By eliminating, you know, the alpha male or female, or you could actually upset the apple cart, so to speak, and create more coyotes being produced.
If you were to remove all the predators, not only would the environment suffer, but you would throw the ecology completely out of balance. You can never do just one thing. That's one of the first laws of ecology.
So anywhere from killing a few to killing many just opens up Pandora's box. They have so many tools and so many ways to compensate for that lethal control.
So in 1996, we learned that this federal agency was going to be using a poison called Compound 1080. None of us knew what it was. None of us knew about the agency that was going to be using this.
Well, the Marin County Livestock and Wildlife Protection Program kicked off probably in 1996 with the controversy around using 1080 collars for predator control.
In addition to Compound 1080, Wildlife Services use another deadly poison called sodium cyanide.
My dad used the cyanide devices here, and whatever animal tugged on them basically was killed. My experience was that you either got a young coyote that probably wasn't the problem, or you got an innocent bystander, so to speak, a fox or something like that.
Millions of innocent animals that are actually helping our ranching and helping our land are being killed indiscriminately.
So when we learned about this poison and the agency behind it, we then learned that this agency had been functioning in Marin County for decades at taxpayer expense. And they were already killing bobcats, badgers, mountain lions, foxes out in West Marin, particularly at the behest of ranchers.
Animal groups interested in protecting wildlife came forward and asked that we try non-lethal approaches.
You know, part of my job as a farmer is to figure out how to coexist with the wildlife. And I really don't like shooting and trapping and killing various animals that I think we ought to share. Share the road.
We sat down with the Department of Ag and said, can we do it a different way? Can we help our ranchers, but in a non-lethal way that listens to the community's needs, that adheres to the ecology of our community, and that recognizes the importance of native wildlife?
I looked at it as that we could take the money that we were using for USDA program and transfer that into a non-lethal program.
And this includes livestock guard dogs, llamas, better fencing. And so it really just took that money that went to pay a federal trapper and turned it into a cost share program that now has been enormously effective.
The ranchers were much more engaged, and they visualized that when they start seeing success, they wanted more success. They wanted fewer predator problems.
They've been very supportive for both fencing and dog protection for our stock, and I think it's been a successful program. It's been helpful to us.
My experience with the dogs and with the system that we have here is that the sheep are safe. And so I hear the coyotes now, and it's just a wonderful bit of wildness.
It's very helpful to have the extra money because we have problems with the llamas and alpacas. There are expenses. They get foxtails in their eyes. So to have some money that I can use for vet bills to keep them in good shape is really important.
I believe today we have 40 guard dogs out on 20 plus ranches. And we have, I think, 35 llamas.
And really, you know, the test comes when you look at how does it help in terms of reducing livestock losses.
Livestock losses from predation has markedly declined. When USDA Wildlife Services was in the county, the total program cost was around $80,000. Since they have left, the program costs have declined
down to around $20,000.
As a result of what we did in Marin County that led to a statewide ban of these poisons, now there is federal legislation to restrict compound 1080 and sodium cyanide. So we're starting to get real recognition that there is a major problem with this agency and a major problem with how we are managing predators in the United States.
The Marin County Livestock and Wildlife Protection Program is just becoming a national model for how to do it right. It's great reduction in depredations, it's become cost effective, and ranchers and farmers have been really much more involved with the natural functioning ecosystem, and the more they learn, the more they can improve those kinds of non-lethal control practices. If you want to keep an ecosystem healthy, you've got to have the whole carnivore complex. You've got to have predators and their prey.
If there were more counties that adopted this and actually implemented it on a serious level like we did here in Marin, they would find that they could be successful as well.
We need wild animals. We need all kinds of wild animals, and the more different kinds of wild animals we have, the better.
Because the reality is that coyotes and other predators are here to stay, and they have an invaluable, pivotal role in maintaining healthy ecosystems. So if we can learn how to coexist with predators, we can really better learn how to coexist with each other.
It's a good feeling to be part of a system that has wild things in it. There is an intrinsic value at night. When the coyotes are singing outside, I always, turn off the stereo when we hear them. We turn off the stereo and open the windows and say, listen, do you hear them? And it's a sense of wildness around you. There is an intrinsic value to that.
Thank you.